If you're new to pixel art or pixel art animation and you would like to see how to create a sequence like this for your own game projects as an intro sequence or some cutscene, I have some tips for you in this video to help you get started with the process. Before we get into the details of this particular animation, if you haven't seen my video on how I created this still image, make sure to check out the video in which I go into the details of how I created these silhouette shapes in the first place. So after I had created this still image, I started animating the UFO that is abducting this poor little cow that is living on this farmland somewhere in the 1950s in the US. First, I started with putting all the important pieces that I was animating onto separate layers because I hadn't done so in the process of creating the still image entirely, which means the UFO went onto its own layer as well as the cow and also the beam that the UFO produces to abduct the cow. I then started to shrink the UFO and let it appear from behind this tree on the right side of the image. So I was going back and forth with the first image that I had created, scaling the UFO to a smaller size and let it appear from behind the tree in a sequence of different keyframes of this animation. I was also playing with the rotation of the UFO, as you can see, so it was not just flying very steadily above the ground, but it had some kind of momentum to it. And I was also making sure that there was some kind of acceleration and deceleration in place so that it looked like the UFO was slowing down when it started to hover above the spot where it was eventually starting to abduct the cow. So I was double checking back and forth if the animation was fluent or not. And I was going here for a more cartoony style of animation, so the acceleration and deceleration of the UFO are a bit more pronounced than in a more realistic setup. So everything is a bit more cartoony on purpose for this piece. And as you can see, the first few frames in which I made the UFO appear on screen in the center of the scenario, I produced those fairly quickly, and then I took almost the same amount of time to fine-tune the movement of the UFO after it had already reached its target destination. Which essentially in the final animation translates to fine movement of slowing down and letting the UFO become more steady while it was hovering above the spot. So this way it makes it feel like the UFO is actually controlled by some aliens that are flying it, trying to get control over the UFO while hovering above the spot that they are targeting. Once I was happy with the movement of the UFO and after it had come to a full stop, I started to work on the beam to appear. And in order to make the whole sequence a bit more dynamic, I decided to create one particular frame in which the tractor beam first appeared and to let this frame become much more bright than all the other frames in order to simulate a kind of flashing movement of the beam hitting the ground. So to that end, I started to highlight all the parts that are not the sky, including the ground, the farm buildings and the trees, to have this flashy moment of the beam appearing on screen. After that was done, I started to actually work on the animation of how the cow is being pulled into the UFO through the tractor beam. So here the same principle applied that I already applied to the UFO itself. So the cow starts to move very subtly by only a few pixels in the first couple of frames and then rapidly speeding up and in the end being pulled in very quickly into the UFO, which when you play back the animation gives the impression of the cow being pulled into the UFO with a lot of force, which is what I was going for here and which nicely adds to the cartoony kind of movements that I was going for here. After the movement of the cow being pulled into the UFO was done, I figured I need to work on the lighting of the scene, because currently the lighting was very static, so there was always just light on all the objects, independent of the beam appearing or disappearing. So I figured the lights on the buildings and the trees should become more prominent in the moment that the light beam occurs. Which is why I started to darken all the light spots on the houses and the trees and the overall scene for all frames in which the UFO was still to appear and to commence the abduction operation. After that, I figured the animation was almost done already, but the car was still kind of very static in the way it was pulled into the UFO. So I figured I wanted to, in addition to just changing the position of the cow over a couple of frames, I also wanted to pronounce more the force with which the cow was pulled into the UFO by letting the cow perform some kind of bending animation, essentially looking like it was really being pulled by its back into the UFO. And I achieved this by letting the head and the tail droop a little bit while the force was acting on the cow, and also slightly extending its legs, which is something you will probably not really notice in the final animation, but it's a nice little touch to further pronounce the force with which the UFO is pulling in the cow. In order to let the UFO fly back with the cow already abducted, I took the simple route by just copy-pasting the first frames in which the UFO was approaching the center of the screen and playing them back in reverse order. I double-checked a few times and I figured that after the abduction operation, the flying movement of the UFO leaving the screen was a bit too slow compared to the initial approach of the UFO. So I started to remove a few keyframes, I think only two or three keyframes I removed from the sequence, just to make sure that the UFO was leaving the screen a bit faster than it initially came onto the screen. And this is how the final result looks. I hope you enjoyed watching the creation process of this little sequence. And if you did, it would be nice to let me know by hitting the like button. And if you would like to see more pixel art from me in the future, make sure to subscribe, and see you next time.